My name's Todd. What's your name, kid?
When you're the best copper. Of friends.
I'm Hound.
Celebrating the spirit of friendship and the triumph of loyalty, Disney's 24th animated feature, The Fox and the Hound, was not only a continuation of a long tradition of excellence in art and storytelling, it was also a turning point in the history of Disney animation.
All the artists that were doing Beauty and the Beast and Aladdin and Mermaid and Rescuers Down Under and the new pictures, this is really our start. This is the picture that we started to take off from. It's quite an interesting time because when it did start out with Willie Reitherman and Frank Thomas and Ollie Johnston, which were all some of Disney's nine old men. They started off the picture and did some of the animation, set some of the characters, got it going, and then they had to pass off the whole picture onto brand new animators that had only been at the studio for a few years.
Frank Thomas, Ollie Johnston, Eric Larson were the old guys saying, you guys will do it. You know, we have all the confidence in the world to it. Someday you're going to do greater things than us. And I was shaking in my boots.
I remember standing behind Ollie as he's going over my drawings and just kind of staring at the top of his head and thinking, this is Ollie Johnston going over my drawings. It was quite an interesting time.
The old animators tried to pass on what knowledge they could to the younger fellows who were coming in, or who had been there for some time but had not had a chance to move on up. And they were very eager, of course, to learn their skills.
Well, copper, me and old chief are gonna teach you all about hunting. Yes, sir.
Besides just the mechanics of animating, we tried to get them interested in what we were interested in their own way, of course, and that is in developing personality. And getting what Walt always asked us to do, which was to get the relationship between characters.
We still had some of the older animators on that, Frank Thomas and Ollie Johnston, two of the nine old men who had gone all the way back to Snow White. They kind of finished their animation careers on The Fox and the Hound.
We knew when we started that we were going to leave, retire, before we even reached the middle of the picture. So we confined most of our effort to the story work and the relationship of the characters.
Oh, I like the relationship between Copper and Chief, where Chief felt this young kid was gradually moving in on him, and eventually he has to sit in the back seat. So true to life, and it's the young guy coming up and replacing the older one.
The passing of the baton was always on my mind. I knew that I was only going to have a short time with those guys there in that hallway where I could go and talk with them.
I was an animator on Fox and Hound. I later moved into story and direction. I think on the later films that we worked on, though, I still did try and apply the sort of lessons that people like Frank and Ollie were trying to drum into us in terms of the importance of character.
I worked on Big Mama, and I watched Pearl Bailey a lot during recording sessions and tried to kind of incorporate aspects of kind of how an owl moves and combine that with how Pearl Bailey would move and trying to fuse those together.
When you're the best of friends, sharing all that you discover, when these moments have passed, will that friendship last? Who can say there's a way? Oh, I hope it never ends. 'Cause you're the best of friends.
It is a strong message, and just the strong underlying dramatic thing of two friends who are separated by circumstances and by society in a way, and it makes a statement about racial prejudice, I think, and trying to overcome that.
Well, there were actually a lot of strong thematic elements underneath Fox and the Hound, things that had to do with bigotry and with people being sort of stereotyped and forced into certain roles, particularly with the Fox and the Hound, who start out as friends and then find out that according to the rules, they're supposed to be enemies, and they have to deal with that and finally come to terms with that.
You shouldn't be over here. You're gonna get us both into a lot of trouble.
Hey, look, I just wanted to see you.
We're still friends, aren't we? Todd, those days are over. I'm a hunting dog now.
Eventually, the friendship reasserts itself, which I think is strong.
What I really enjoyed animating there was when Todd the fox went back to save Copper, his friend, against the worst possible odds, this huge bear that established as a monster, and that this fox would go against all odds to do the impossible thing. Now, that really captured my heart, and that's what excited me.
So a new generation of Disney artists advanced. And although The Fox and the Hound was the end of an era at Disney Animation, it was also a new beginning. The great Disney animators of the past left a legacy of artistic brilliance, unforgettable characters, and a mastery of story, action, comedy, and heart that would be proudly carried into the future.
Copper, you're my very best friend.
And you're mine too, Todd.
And we'll always be friends forever, won't we?
Yeah, forever.